No credit card? No problem. Hey guys, Tara here for DNews, and if you are sick of hearing about all these credit card and data breaches, you are not alone. Michael's Craft Store, one of the happiest places on earth, announced recently that two separate 8-month-long security breaches at its stores last year may have exposed as many as 3 million customer credit and debit cards. Between this, last year's Target breach, and the crazy data theft that happened in South Korea earlier this year, it might be time to consider some alternative payment methods, and that is exactly what one Swedish startup is trying to do. Quixter is a company founded by former students at Sweden's Lund University, and it allows users to pay for items at a checkout with a simple swipe of their hand. It's a new form of biometric scanning that uses the unique pattern of veins inside your palm to identify you. Unlike fingerprint scanners, which can leave behind prints, the creators of this technology claim that there is no possible way to commit fraud with this system because it doesn't require physical contact with the user. The other obvious benefit is that it reduces the amount of time consumers spend waiting in line at stores. The hand swipe itself takes only a couple seconds, but Quixter also requires users to enter the last 4 digits of their phone number, which isn't so much an added security measure as it is a way for users to see exactly how much they're being charged before they actually pay for something. Similar vein scanning hardware has been used in Japanese and Brazilian ATMs for years now, but this is one of the first instances of it being used specifically for payment processing. US company Bio, formerly known as Pulse Wallet, was technically the first to develop this technology, for which they claim near-perfect results, citing only one false positive for every 1.25 million scans. Unfortunately, it may be a while before anyone sees Quixter's technology outside of Sweden. The system is currently active in only a handful of locations surrounding the university's campus, with a total of around 1,600 users, mostly students. The company does plan to expand their reach, but the biggest hurdle, they say, is getting businesses and banks on board. Signing up as a user is as easy as going to a store, registering your social security and phone numbers, and then linking your bank account online. Seems simple enough, but I've seen a lot of mixed responses to this news online. Let us know in the comments below if this is something you would ever consider using, and for more episodes of DNews, subscribe here.